Good evening. Thanks for joining us here tonight. I'm Tori Ryden. In just a few weeks, we all head to the polls. In Biddeford, there are a lot of issues on the ballot, including what to do with Biddeford High School. The school is in dire need of repair and could be at risk of losing its accreditation if those problems aren't fixed, and soon. School officials are trying to convince voters to approve a $34 million tax increase to pay for the work. And tonight, they escorted residents through the school halls to show them the problems. News 8's Will Lewis, who went along on the tour, joins us now. So, Will, how bad is it?
Well, Tori, some of the students told us the problems are so bad that when visiting sports teams play at Biddeford High School, the visitors don't even want to use the bathrooms. And that's just one small part of the problem. Other issues include mold on the windows and lockers so small, students can't even put their coats in them. The goal of the tour is to inform the public and hope they will vote yes for the renovations.
The tour starts out on the stairs of the high school. Stairs so badly damaged they can no longer be patched, but need to be replaced. Once inside the school, the goal is to see what $35 million will fix.
My daughter's in eighth grade, so she's going to be coming here soon, so I want a good education for her, and I'm just looking out to do the best for the city of Biddeford.
From bathrooms that are small to rooms that have different problems.
This is a social studies classroom. This is Mr. Redmond's classroom. I actually opened it. You can see that you can smell it has an odor.
Not only do the classrooms smell, water is leaking on the inside of the single pane windows. The seals are cracked and the air quality is poor. Student guides say it's bad every day.
It's quite obvious that there's a desperate need for renovation here at the high school.
Even some small upgrades would make a big difference, like having a place for students to put their books and coats, something these small lockers can't provide.
I never use my locker. I have one of these lockers.
The most glaring problem came downstairs on the first floor when Principal Britton Wolf showed people a wall that students have seen leak water.
This damaged wall has been patched and repaired many times because of water damage from outside.
There are two other walls just like that. While people saw exposed electrical boxes and small spaces, they left with signs asking people to vote yes for the renovations, but say it won't stop there. They want more people to see the school.
For people who have not seen the school, they need to come and see it. It's blatant that the school needs the renovations.
I'm going to encourage them to come take a look at the building. You know, once you see it, you'll probably make up your mind on how you're going to vote.
Tonight's meeting was just the first of four tours around the high school, and of course, those that came out say they are going to try and gather up as many people as they can to take the tour and hopefully sway them to vote yes on the renovation project. In the newsroom, Will Lewis, News 8.
All right, thank you.